In one of the earlier chapters we covered this quarter, we talked about the difference between prokaryotic and eukaryotic cells, in that eukaryotic cells have a nucleus, and within that nucleus is contained the nuclear DNA. Now, prokaryotic cells have DNA associated with them, but it's not contained within the nucleus. So this particular figure is showing a fluorescently labeled nucleus that has the chromosomes or the DNA within it that are not condensed. Now, you can expose the dividing cell, cell dividing by mitosis, to special chemicals that will stop cell division or arrest cell division. And then you can break open the nucleus to release the chromosomes. And then you can fluorescently paint the chromosomes different colors. Now that allows you to create what are called homologous pairs. So what you see in the corner in this box is said to be a karyotype, which is an arrangement of homologous chromosomes in the karyotype, in this case humans. So you can see how the coloring or the fluorescent labeling of the chromosomes would facilitate the process of creating a karyotype. So I had a student who used to work at OHSU who was a karyotype technician, and this is exactly what he did. He would take pictures of chromosomes and cut and paste them to create the karyotype. So chromosomes just don't pop out of the nucleus arranged in this way. And so you can sort them on the basis of size and centromere location and the fluorescent colors. So what we're looking at is an arrangement of the homologous chromosome pairs. Remember, in humans, the diploid chromosome number, or designated 2N, is equal to 46. That means there are 23 pairs of homologous chromosomes. And homologous chromosomes are similar in size and centromere location, and also in the genetic information that they carry. So we're looking at the human karyotype. The first 22 pairs of chromosomes are said to be autosomes, or non-sex chromosomes. The last pair of chromosomes are the sex chromosomes. Now, if the individual has two X chromosomes, then the individual is phenotypically a female. If there's an X and a Y chromosome present, then the individual would be predicted to be male. Now, there can be chromosomal problems that result in different sexes. For example, if a region of the Y chromosome that determines maleness is deleted, then the individual can have an X and a Y chromosome, but will develop female anatomically because of the mutation to the region of the Y chromosome. So we're talking about what's normal here. So you can see that the chromosomes start large and go down to smaller, and then the last pair of chromosomes, again, is the sex chromosomes, which we use to determine whether the individual is male or female.